And on gender issues, where do we need to make, I mean, you've been right at the center of driving change and driving change on the council and on many other ways. But we're looking, both of us, for like, what are the breakthrough things? What are the things that don't get talked about that could really make, and that's not to take away from all of the step-by-step regulations and laws that to guarantee equality, but at a kind of a cultural or political consciousness level, what needs to happen?
I think in many cases there needs to be an I'll say, you know, there's opportunities that I've certainly experienced that my mother never did, and other women and other generations have never been able to have. I think what we really need to see again is not a stepping back or a shutting up, but a stepping up of men. I think women have proven that we can or have to handle being the breadwinner, being the comforter, being the house cleaner, being all things in a household. And as there's that additional tax of literally working 9 to 5 and then another 24 hours, as even when they are married and have a male partner. So what I have not seen and I don't see enough of is the intergenerational growth of men to step up into those spaces that are considered quote unquote domestic or women's work. And men being able to show that they can handle that as well, lighten the burden, and they're not less of men because they are staying at home, taking care of the children, being caretakers to their parents, and doing that work as well, uncompensated. There needs to be a push from men organizing men about gender equality. For their own mental health, for their own emotional health, for their own ability to be great fathers. And that, I think, when it comes to gender equity, women aren't confused about where we're oppressed or what solutions we need. Men are.